Ashley Logan. What's going on, girl?
Hey, y'all.
How you been?
I've been good. Busy.
Yeah, I know. That's what it is, working hard. Got a lot of adventures going on and all that, right?
Yes.
And that's, you know, let the world know, like, you know, for some of the things you got going on right now and stuff.
Okay, well, for all y'all that don't know, my name is Ashley Logan, a.k.a. the Backshot Queen. Basically, I'm just an urban video vixen slash magazine model. I've been featured in magazines such as Smooth, Smooth Girl, Straight Stuntin', Black Men's, Fed, Sweets, Riding Big. Oh, God, this. Too many to name, next level. And videos that you've probably seen me in or remember me in are Twister's Wetter, the Dreams Rockin' That Thing remix. I was Fab's girl in the video. K-Slay's off of his album that's coming out, the Block Stars video featuring Ray J, Busta, Jim Jones, yeah, Yo Gotti. And I started off all my videos with G-Unit. I did about 3 G-Unit videos. Really, my past experience, it's really all who you know. You can be ugly and not even like fit for this industry, but it's all about who you know. Fortunately for me, once I moved up to New York City, because I'm originally from Orlando, Florida, I hooked up with K-Slay, who is my manager, and he shot me for his magazine that is going on the third year, and I shot for it, and my pictures came out crazy. And when I came out in my first issue with Coco on the front cover, people were like, you know, who's that girl? So he saw like how in demand I was, so he stuck with me. And then he had signed me up for a couple other projects, and I came through and did a really good job, and everybody loved me, so he was like, all right, I need you on my team. So I am, he doesn't manage models. He doesn't have like a modeling, management company or anything like that, but he manages me. So I'm very thankful and fortunate, and that's it. Yeah, I have a degree from the University of Central Florida. I'm a criminal justice major. I'm not using it right now because basically, I tell people this, like, I've done the hard part. I did the 4 years of college, got my degree, pursuing my master's. So when I get ugly and old and can't, you know, be the big booty model or anything like that, show off my body, then I'll go ahead and I will use my degree. Oh my gosh. Well, everybody really, sometimes assumes or speculates if it's real or not because I'm white. There's no black in me, there's no Spanish in me. I'm Irish and Hungarian, so people are always, you know, but can you tell?
Yeah, let's see what that's about.
Can you tell?
Oh my God, see that on the table? Wow.
I let people, you know, speculate. They can do whatever because, you know, regardless if it's real or fake, I'm still gonna be doing shoots and getting interviews and, you know, doing this. So, you know, like, it's whatever. And I don't, you know, like, nobody ever says anything when girls have fake boobs. Mm-hmm. So it's like, if a girl wants to get her ass done, like, why should you care?
Yeah,
still,
yeah.
You know? So,
yeah.
Yeah. It's whatever, my measurements are 34, 26, 43, so. My name, The Backshot Queen, is actually, it's a song, it's a Red Cafe song, so I took it from there and just ran with it. Mm-hmm. And my name, Ashley Logan, that is my name. Ashley, my first name, Logan, my middle name. So, yeah, that's where the name comes from. A lot of people still mistake me as a porn chick. I'm not even gonna say porn star because I'm so tired of these chicks that do porn that are like, I'm a porn star. You're a porn chick, you. I don't know. But yeah, I'm not. Definitely not.
Have you had thoughts of doing it or?
No, I haven't. Yeah. Nope, because I've done something. I've done something with my life. I have a lot more to do. I feel that maybe if I was trapped and I had nothing to live for, maybe I would do it. Mm-hmm. I have a couple of friends in the porn business, and they know who they are, and you're my friend for a reason. Mm-hmm. All the other chicks that I've met in porn, I just am like really disgusted. Like they don't carry themselves good. They're always trying to fight with other people. Like we're something. Well, and personally me, they always try to like pick fights with me, and it's like, dude, I don't do what you do. Like there's no competition. There's no nothing. Why are you? I don't want to say I'm picky, but I guess I really actually kind of am, because I put it like this. When I say I'm dating someone, like if I'm smashing you, I'm dating you. and really, I mean, I'm not 18 anymore, so I don't like to just go around smashing a whole bunch of different guys. Yeah. So really, yeah, like I'm the kind of person where my relationships are really public. And of course, like I said, that one relationship that I was in for the past 3 years, that one was very public, and I kind of learned my lesson now to where like I'm not gonna, the relationships that I do have in the future, I'm not gonna make them as public as I did, because a lot of drama comes with, you know, having two people in the industry that are together. It's just crazy. Something special. with my man or who I'm dating, who I'm smashing. yeah, I would say that like anything goes. Uh-huh. A lot of people, people that I hang around, they're like, damn, Ashley, you're so crude. Like I don't like to tell what I do. I will in an interview. Like if you get real, like whatever with it, like it's an interview. I'm gonna tell you. But I guess I'm definitely the definition of like a freak behind closed doors with that person. Like I said, I'm not 18 anymore, so it's not like I'm just going around like whoever I mess with, I'm gonna do it with. But the few people that I do see, yeah. Yeah. And I'm not gonna lie and say I like all types of men. No, I like black men.
Yeah.
That's what I like. Honestly, first I'm gonna say this. I think people like doing interviews with me because I tell the truth. I'm just gonna put it like that. And of course, you know, you ask other models this question or other ladies this question, they're like, oh, I like all types of guys. You're a liar. If you're a female that has, you know, I'm gonna take me, came up here by myself, no family, no friends. I have, you know, my own apartment, it's beautiful, I have my own car, I have a degree, I make my own money. I want a man that is capable of taking care of me, but I don't need him to. Of course, I don't need him to. So what does that mean? With the things that I do, I need someone that's secure with what I do, so basically that knows what I go through. And I want someone, so if you want to say like there's someone, I basically date people that are known. It didn't used to be like that, but things have changed ever since I started doing this. And people also need to understand that a lot of times you hear like the video models and the video vixens, oh, they're groupies or groupies. Like, this is what I do. This is my job. And the industry, the rappers, the athletes, this is who I'm around. So that's who I'm going to date. It's not that I'm a groupie. I can't be a groupie. I'm in the industry with them. Like, I don't chase after these men. They chase after me. So... That's all good. If guys come up to me and approach me, I don't just brush them off, but I will brush them off the same way that I brush an athlete or a rapper or someone in the industry off. Yeah. They try to put all of us models together in a competition. Basically the white girls, which there really isn't very many, which I just want to let people know, like, seriously, like, if I wasn't white, I wouldn't get the interviews that I get, the videos that I get, the hostings that I get, the magazines that I get, because it would just be me against a whole bunch of urban models that are predominantly black and
so
Spanish.
So the game is like that, in a sense.
Yeah, man, like, I get what I get because I'm white. Mm-hmm. And I'm very thankful for it, and I worked really hard, so. Yeah, girls don't like me. And really, I don't care. I had someone tell me before, like, people don't rock with you. Haven't you seen that? Like, I don't care. Like, you don't pay my bills. I am a bitch as far as, like I said, I'm up here by myself. So I have to have this wall, because if someone messes with me, it's not like I can't just, like, run to my friends and be like, go get her, or go, you know, take care of them. Like, I can't do that. So I'm the kind of person where if you're another female and we're like doing a shoot together or we're hosting a party, I'm not gonna go out of my way to say hello to you. But the minute that you come and say hello to me, like, you'll be able to tell, like, I'm really cool and I am down to earth, and I'm not here with this wall up as in, like, this is competition. Because really, like I said, there's only a handful of white girls doing this. So what's the competition? Like, there's no competition between me and, like, a black girl that's doing the same thing I'm doing. And I mean, I've done a lot, so I have a reason to be confident. You know, my name is out there. I worked really hard. But I'm cool. I really am cool. I think the first time I decided that I wanted to model was when I was in Orlando. I had just turned 18 and I went to, like, my first club. You know how they always have, like, camera guys in the club, like, taking pictures and stuff? And the camera guys were always taking pictures of me. And I was always seeing how the pictures were coming out. Like, you can be beautiful and you can be gorgeous and have a beautiful face, nice body, and then when you take pictures and you sit in front of the camera, you look like shit.
Talk about that.
and you're just not photogenic. Yeah. And that's another thing, is that another reason why I love doing these interviews is because I have seen so many girls in a magazine, and then when you see them in real life, they look like shit. But it's okay though, because if there's a difference between video vixens, video models, video girls, magazine models, and bitches that just get in front of a camera, will take pictures, Photoshop the hell out of themselves, and then be put in a magazine. Cool. I know you're not getting paid, because you don't get paid, for all y'all that don't know. If a female tells you that is in the kind of modeling that I do, that they are living off of videos or magazines, they're lying. Because I don't get paid very much for that shit, if you get paid at all. For example, the Bedrock video with Lil Wayne. They saw my pictures. I got casted for it as a main girl. And when I went to go speak to them, oh, by the way, Ashley, we just want to let you know there's no budget for this video, so therefore you're not going to be getting paid. Okay, so it's like, and that's just an example. Hello, that's just, you know, Lil Wayne, Kanye West, like, you really don't. I mean, I've been fortunate, like, I've been paid. Like, I've gotten very good money. As much as up to like $1,500 for a video. But where the real money is after you do these videos, so it's like you have to take the good with the bad. I'll do a Lil Wayne video or something like that, which I haven't yet, but I'll do one. And then off of that video and being on TV, people will book me to host parties. So host parties, that's where people see you. That's where you get paid, so you get paid to party. That's where all the money comes from, is hosting parties. Hey, yo. Basically, y'all can look out for another Straight Slant magazine coming out. I'm in a lot of those, whether it be if I have a spread in them or if Slay just goes ahead and puts like a page or a picture of me in there. I'm in that all the time. My Black Men's 40 on 40 issue just came out. My Smooth Top 100 just came out. Magazines, and like I said, the Papoose Data Grip video, I just came out in that. Mm-hmm. And then the Black Stars video, I just did a little cameo in that. And that's it right now for the videos. I'm not really doing too many videos because I'm at the point where I've done so many that I'm waiting for, like, the next big one. You know, like, if it's not huge and it's not big, I'm not gonna do it. I don't care to do it. Hey y'all, what's up? This is Ashley Logan, aka the Backshot Queen, and you are watching Blue Collar Television. We are here at Soul Food NYC. And before I sign off, just want to give a huge shout out to my homie C Major in Hollywood, the producer. Bye y'all.